Hello, and welcome to day four of our Earth Week gardening series. Today, I'm going to break down what kinds of organic waste are best to include in your home compost. So let's start off with the items that can and should be added to your home compost. First off, and perhaps most obviously, fruit and vegetable scraps should be added to compost. But beyond just those, you can also add coffee grounds and tea leaves, as well as the coffee filters you might use, provided they're of the unbleached variety. You can also add dry and healthy plant material and yard clippings to your compost. Dry and healthy being the key words that you'll want to focus on in this area. You can also add shredded pieces of unbleached paper, such as newsprint or brown paper bags to your compost pile. And you can also add bread and grains, sawdust and wood chips, and nutshells to your compost pile. So these things are all great and will break down in a natural way and are great candidates to add to a compost pile. In this second category, we have materials that can certainly be added to your compost provided they meet a certain set of criteria first. So first up, we have dryer lint, which you should only add if your laundry contains no synthetic materials like nylon or polyester. If you have lint from cotton, linen, or wool, or other natural fibers like that, go ahead and add it to your compost pile. Next up is pet hair, a small amount of which can actually help to deter rodents from your compost, entering your compost if you have an open air compost situation in your yard. But too much will sort of choke out your compost. It won't allow it to properly oxygenate and it can start to smell, which you'll probably want to avoid. Next up is eggshells. You can add eggshells to your compost pile once they've been rinsed and then broken down a little bit. So if you just have two neat halves of a beautiful eggshell, just break them down a little bit first before throwing them in your pile. You can also add used napkins and paper towels to your compost pile, provided that they're unbleached and they're not greasy. If they're wet, it's totally okay. So if you've just used your paper towels to wipe up a juice spill or a coffee spill or whatever, you can go ahead and throw those in your compost pile. But if you've used them to dab off the grease on a slice of pizza, don't put that one in your compost. Next up is cardboard, which can be added to your compost pile if it's torn up into little pieces. If you've just bought something like a fridge or even just a big toaster or something, you probably don't want to tear those huge boxes up, so just go ahead and recycle those. But if you have, say, an egg carton that's not the foam kind, like it's the papery kind, go ahead, shred that up and throw that in your compost pile. Last but not least is grass, which if it's dry and healthy, can be added in small sprinklings to your compost pile. Like pet hair, too much grass will start to choke out your pile and not allow it to oxygenate properly, which we're trying to avoid here. And last but not least is the category of materials that should not under any circumstances be added to your compost. The first is diseased plant material. So if you have diseased plants in your compost, when you go to spread out the compost in your yard later, you're spreading that disease. So you'll want to just get rid of those by a different means than composting. You'll also want to avoid animal products of all kinds. So that's meat, bones, fish, dairy products, and animal waste. Don't go great in home compost piles. They really start to have a strong odor as they decompose, so you'll want to avoid adding those as well. You'll also want to avoid coal ashes and weeds. Weeds for the same reason as diseased plants. If you put weeds, especially those that have gone to seed, in your compost pile, you'll just spread the weeds all over your yard when you spread the compost, which you want to, I'm assuming, avoid. And last but not least is compostable plastics. They are only compostable under industrial circumstances. So unless you have an industrial composter in your backyard, which you certainly do not, your backyard compost pile won't achieve a high enough heat to actually break down those plastics. So that's all I have for you today. Hopefully that helps you cultivate your compost. Join me tomorrow to learn a little bit about microgreens, a fast-yielding, nutrient-dense crop that you can grow year-round inside your home. Bye!